I gotta tell you, it's a real honor to introduce him. I think you all know him quite well. His wife, Liz Raese, John Raese, who's right back here, would be a tremendous United States Senator right now, by the way. Woo! And he's a tremendous leader. You will not find more generous folks in the state of West Virginia than John and Liz Raese. No more generous. The stories I hear of them and your generosity, you don't tell these stories very well. I think you're a boxer at mid-lake. You like to counter punch? Donald Trump likes to counter punch. But it's a real honor to bring to the stage John Raese.
Number one, without energy, I think there's a certain woman that is running for president right now that doesn't like that word, but without energy, we don't have capitalism, we don't have manufacturing, we don't have production, we don't have anything. And that's a common core. The cornerstones of capitalism are energy and private property. And who is controlling both of those is called the Environmental Protection Agency. Who runs the Environmental Protection Agency? Is it Joe Manchin? No. Is it Barack Obama? You see, the Environmental Protection Agency comes from the executive part of our government. It's run from the executive part of our government. So who's ever the president of the United States runs the EPA. It's that simple. Now we have a choice, don't we? We can turn it over to a leftist Marxist named Hillary Clinton, or we can turn it over to one of the greatest businessmen in the history of the United States, Donald Trump. That's our choice. That's our choice. Government doesn't create jobs. Let me say that again. Government never creates jobs. What Hillary wants to do is give our miners relief. I want to give Hillary some relief. And when we do that in November, there's a whole new ball game in West Virginia, I can tell you right now. Donald Trump has signed the front of a check. He's one of those guys, I know a few of them around, that we go out and we make the speculation. We take the challenges. We take the risks. And how are we rewarded? With government down our backs. It has gone to attention right now. It's overboard. It won't work anymore. We have an opportunity, and probably our last opportunity, right now. We are past the 11th hour. You heard Governor Cole talk a little bit about the ills and the ails of the state of West Virginia. That's not going to cease unless you and I do our jobs coming up in November. We have 6 months to do our job. And it can be done. This is an extremely winnable race. With Hillary's statements on coal, we can win West Virginia, Pennsylvania, Ohio, North Carolina, Virginia, and Michigan, and Indiana. It's over. It is over. Those states make it over. And they know it. They know it. What are we going to do now? We're going to elect somebody that has the capitalism, the experience, the business. to make America great again. Thank you very much.
We'd rather have it too quiet than too loud.
The folks are really close here. I mean, tremendous remarks. And that simple slogan, make America great again. Right, Ronald Reagan's slogan, that's what we all know we need to do. But I want to point to this again, make sure we still have